Hi everyone, welcome to Dr. Z Cafe. 大家好，欢迎您来到朱博士咖啡屋。안녕하세요주박사의카페오신것을환영합니다
May it's Asia Pacific American Heritage Month. We surely want to hear stories about happy and successful Asian Pacific Americans. I present Dr. Yan Li. Yan was named after an oil field in China.She has worked on many oil and gas fields in the world in almost all major international oil gas companies before she retires in USA. She is well recognized in her wide network. For example, the late former President George W. Bush invited her to his home. She is extremely energetic and healthy, and her family is happy. So how did she achieve all those? Let's hear it directly from Dr. Yan Li.
Welcome, Dr. Yan Li.
Thank you, Dr. Zhu. I'm glad to participate.
We're so happy to have you. Can you tell us about yourself, Dr. Li?
Yes, I'm graduating in 1982 in China as a petroleum engineering major. And in 1985, I came to the United States for my graduate school at Stanford for my master's degree and University of Oklahoma for my PhD.After I got my doctorate degree, I worked for several U.S. companies.
You worked for a few companies. Why?
Yes. And there was a lot of oil price increase and decrease in last 20, 30 years and company merge acquisition. So that's the main reason I moved from one oil company to another.So I worked for ARCO International, and then BP bought Amoco and ARCO. Then I worked for Tesco, and Chevron bought Tesco. And I worked for Shell and Chevron later. So I actually move around because of merger acquisition.
It seems like you have worked for almost all major oil and gas companies who operate in the U.S.
Yes, I got almost all the offers.In 1999, when the oil price dropped to $10, my lovely company, ARCO International, was sold. At that time, one of the senior executives asked me, BP is going to close your office in Plano, Texas. What are you going to do? I said, I don't know. He sent a letter to his counterpart in Philips and Chevron and Tesco. He wrote a very nice letter, tell them, this is the highest product person in my company, and I believe it will be useful for your company. Within 2 weeks, I got three interviews and immediately got three job offers from each interviewer.
That's so amazing. When the oil price is low, you achieved multiple offers.
I think I'm very, very lucky in the last 30 years in the United States. I made a lot of friends. I got the first year I come to the United States in 85. I got a summer job with a company called CER Corporation. And then I got a summer job with Marvel.And I have seven summer jobs in my 7 years graduate school.
Such an amazing story. You probably have lots of milestones in your career. Did you actively seek to change your career path?
Yes, I did. In 1992, I had a good job in Denver with a small company called Best Enterprise. My salary was increased 30% in first year. And my vice president, Jim Grave, really, really likes.After 3 years work for BASS, I decided to work for major oil company because major oil company drill a well in deep water will spend $200 million. And a small company buy a field in Rocky Mountain, we only pay like $30 million. People ask me, do you want to be a bigger fish in a small pond or a small fish in a big pond? And I choose to move to a major oil company to learn everything and to see the big scale of the project. So I moved from BASS to ARCO.And my vice president, Jim Graves, last day come to my office, talk to me. He said, you are better than 99% of Americans. and you are Asian woman, and you must remember when you go to a major oil company, someone may want to push
really?
You down. Yeah, he said someone may want to push you down. You must remember business is business. You are better than anyone else.
Hey, this AP really cared about you.
Yes, we are a good friend. And I saw him last year. He already retired many years, and we're still good friends. Okay, I have another changing without a merger acquisition, which is I moved from Shell to Chevron. I had a good time in Shell. You and I both work for Shell. I was the president of Asian Network. Yeah, we have Japan. We have 27 Asian countries employees, 670 people in Houston work for Shell. Shell gave us some activity fee, $30,000 per year. Let us run the meeting, mentoring meeting, everything, education for the Asian people. And I do have a good time. And a lot of executives like Mark Lenners, who used to be Shell International President, Joao Rastucci, who is the North American CEO, they are on our board for the Japan. But at the last year with Shell, I realized that there was a glass ceiling. So I look at my career with ARCO and the BASS. I was young and never feel any glass ceiling. My salary increase every year. My boss likes me. I have good skill, best ranking in the company. But at the Shell, I realized the moving space is small. So I made the decision I'm going to move to Chevron because Chevron has more space for Asian people grow up.
Indeed, Mark Lernard and Raul Rastucci, Richard Sears, Fred Hoffman, Fran Lohr,
and Wim Wallach. There were senior executives who recognized great contributions from Asian employees.
However, the system is hard to change.
Yeah. So my best job with Chevron, I have three jobs. All of them are good. My first job is 3 years work for the global review team. And I see all the major CapEx projects around the world. And after 3 years work, Chevron moved me to China. We got a gas field development. I went to there as a chief petroleum engineer to do the overall development plan. And I have a good time, which is close to my parents. Mm-hmm. And then after 3 years, Chevron moved me back to Angola and I fly to Angola 3 times per year. So all the time with Chevron, I really feel very, very happy.
Moving to Chevron proved to be a very wise move.
Yes, yes. So it's just a good timing over there. I actually meet the CEO of Chevron, Dave already, and John Wilson in Beijing, the people's hall to sign the PSC contract with Chinese company at that time.
Working so hard, how did your family feel?
I have a simple family, only husband and my son. I have a big family with my parents, my sister, small family, just my husband and my son. My son already gets used to my hard working. When I was in graduate school, I always get up at 2:00. I went to school, pick up him at 3 p.m., I work with him for the homework. Then I tell my son it's 7:30, go to take a shower. And 8:00, go to bed. I will tell you the story. He was in first grade at that time. So every day, 8:30, he's sleeping. And I sleep for 2 hours. At 1:00 a.m., I get up, go to office to work on my dissertation. Then I continue work on daytime with nonstop. And I think if you work 14 hours per day,
wow.
20 hours per day is different. I think the kids, their eye is better than their ear. Sometimes they don't listen to you when they were in teenager, but they can see how do you do. So if you work hard, they will work hard in the future. And when I present the SP paper in 1992, I asked my son, sit down beside me. He can correct my English, actually. But he says, how do I do with a conference meeting? And now he can present to everyone in his company. He became vice president at 29 years old. He actually graduated from UT Austin Business School with a straight A, 4.0 GPA, and he had bachelor and master degree in 5 years in UT Austin, and the dean wrote me a letter tell me, your son ranking top one from 700 graduates.
And your son is VP already at such a young age.
It's not easy to teach teenager. So you got to remember, when your kids become teenager, you will not treat them as kids anymore. They are like your friend. You have to support him. You have to let him know you always support him. When my son was first year in high school, I took him to Stanford University. I sent him to Roland Hall, the petroleum department chairman at that time. And I tell Roland, I said, Roland, this is my son. He's going to go to university after 4 years. Can you talk to him about university? So I dropped my son in Roland's office. I went outside, let him talk to my son for half hour. And my son was really excited to listen to Roland. And Roland told him, if you want to come to Stanford, not only the SAT, you need to do something special. So next year, he went to China for a holiday, 2 weeks in Nanjing, Shanghai, Suzhou, Hangzhou, and Beijing. Every night, he will write down what did he see, the culture, everything in China. He write down in English. After 2 weeks, he came back, he typed his story, and my husband translated to Chinese. Then we published his first book called Asian Sky in English and Chinese. And he with a lot of pictures. So he's really happy with, at that age, have a first published book.
He became a published author in high school.
That's amazing. And his daddy helped. Your husband helped. Right. What a happy family.
It is hard work. It's happy. And the last 30 years, I have a good time work for every company. And I just want to all the Asian American in United States know a couple of things. And the first is you need to keep a positive attitude. Make a friend as much as possible. The friend not just Asian, but also every nationality. People always have good and bad, but it's not because of your color of skin. And also get high education and keep your skill on the top. I was ranking as top reservoir engineer in ARCO because I did a good history match for one of the 20 years water flooding oil field. And the people said that they never see such a beautiful history match. So it's good to do the keep top skill. And think about the highlight yourself each year. And we call the 20-80 rule. You use 80% of your time to do 20% very highlight, shining things. And then you can use another 20% of your time to do another 80% regular thing. So each year, make sure you can rank in high in your company.
Dr. Yanni, a lot of people want to be ranked high. How did you achieve that? Are you a superwoman or you just work super hard?
No, I'm not a superwoman, but I remember one of the vice presidents from Shell told us, you have to run 2 times long to reach the same distance as other people because you are Asian. So you need to work hard.
What a sober observation and admit from the Shell senior leader.
Everyone is smart. So in order to rank in high, you have to be special. And also you need to set up your career. What do you really want to do? If you really want to do petroleum engineer, you have a good attitude. You are learning, you're doing, you are happy. And then you can keep your good health, work-life balance. Take care of your family and friend, and you're going to have a good time.
I do feel your positive energy wherever you go. Thank you so much, Dr. Yan Li, for your advice for us all.
Thank you.
I hope next year in Asia Pacific's Heritage Month, we'll have more people like Dr. Yan Li. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you, Dr. Zhu.
Hi, all. I hope you enjoyed Dr. Lee's story. If you have not liked or subscribed yet, would you please do it now? See you next time. 下次见。塔麦帕。